Getting typecast in as the dumb blonde in Hollywood can either go terribly wrong, or it could go great. Actress Sue Ane Langdon suffered from the same problem, but how she managed to deal with this embarrassing typecasting is really fascinating. Stick around to discover more about how being called the dumb blonde of Hollywood affected this actress. Sue Langdon had a pretty rough childhood. Langdon was born in Paterson, New Jersey, and since then has lived in about 25 states. When Sue Ane was 2, her widowed mother was left to support herself and Sue all alone. She became a voice instructor and directed student theater and music productions at the several colleges where she taught. Langdon later made her debut at the age of 5 in one of these shows. Growing up mainly in the states of Texas, Idaho, Montana, Utah, and Oregon nurtured Sue's love of the West and formed her funny cowboyish attitude. After studying 4 years in New York and working on and off Broadway, she headed for Hollywood. Sue had the leads in several student productions at Coe College in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, and later at Montana State College. Her first professional break was in summer stock in Montana. She eventually worked her way east and joined a touring company of Most Happy Fella. Later, she went to Las Vegas as a member of the chorus of a Ziegfeld Follies review. A movie scout then signed her for a role in The Great Imposter with Tony Curtis. She didn't set the movie world on fire, but a string of television offers still continued to come towards her. One role, like a siren on the series Mike Hammer in 1959, attracted the attention of a producer of Bachelor Father. The series led her to a successful career in acting. On the set, she wore a very tight dress to get cast in Mike Hammer. She was initially keeping her hopes up for a Foxy role, but when she showed up at the producer's office, Sue was wearing a simple kind of dress. He looked at the actress again and decided she should be just right acting as John Forsythe's secretary, which wasn't a part Sue wanted at all. However, she accepted, and her career on screen kept on progressing from there. Her first big break was as a regular on the TV series Bachelor Father with John Forsythe, where she worked from 1959 to 1961. She made her film debut in The Great Imposter with Tony Curtis. In 1962, she appeared on the cover of Life magazine. Her stops after that included a brief residence in Delaware, Ohio, but most of her time was spent in the Southwest, mostly Texas. She made many TV guest appearances throughout the 60s, including shots on The Andy Griffith Show, McHale's Navy, The Dick Van Dyke Show, Bonanza, The Wild Wild West, and Gunsmoke. In most of her films, Sue Ane played the funny girl. It's probably because, well, because she was funny. In both of her appearances in Elvis films, Sue Ane played a second girl part rather than the leading lady. In Roustabout, she was Madame Mijenot, the carnival's fortune teller who flirts with Elvis but steers him back to Joan Freeman. In Frankie and Johnny, she's Mitzi, the girl who tells on. In between these two films, she made a comedy western with Glenn Ford and Henry Fonda, The Rounders, and later appeared with Henry Fonda again in The Cheyenne Social Club, another comedy western with James Stewart. Soon as she knew it, the actress was one of the dozens of attractive young actresses who became widely known to the silver screens in the late 1950s and throughout the 60s. She made countless appearances. Some were beautiful but serious, while others were beautiful but usually bad. Langdon was the whole package. She was cute and funny and attractive as well. She started to understand she was considered as a dumb blonde. Sadly, the worst thing she ever did in front of the whole public's eye was to appear in the program Jackie Gleason, which was brought to CBS in the fall of 1962. Here, she played Alice Cramden. The network lured Gleason back to weekly television, even though he had starred with Paul Newman in a movie hit, The Hustler, that turned Gleason into an in-demand actor. Gleason wanted Audrey Meadows to join his new show and play Alice Cramden in the Honeymooners sketches that would be part of a weekly 60-minute series that would also feature other skits and musical numbers. Meadows turned down the offer, so Gleason cast Sue, who had previously delivered impressive performances on several television shows, usually as a funny and charismatic character. To promote the new show, Gleason, Langdon, and some other actresses, dubbed the Glee Girls, boarded a train in Los Angeles and headed to New York, making a few stops along the way. The train was called the Great Gleason Express. When Jackie Gleason's new television show was aired on a Saturday night, it was still the same kind of program it had been a few years ago. But when the show swung into its first Honeymooners sketch, people started noticing something different. Alice Cramden was played by another actress. Langdon had replaced Audrey Meadows, a mainstay of the old Gleason programs. Gleason tried to convince Meadows to join his new series, but her recent marriage and her Hollywood success and that touch of mink made her reluctant to return back to New York for a television show unless the price was really high. The search for a new leading lady ended when Gleason met the blonde-haired Sue Ane Langdon. A mutual agent arranged the introduction and impressed Gleason by reciting the actress's long list of TV appearances. Now, the Gleason newcomer had to win over fans who'd inevitably compare Langdon's performance with Meadows' version of Alice. Although Langdon was considered a comedian, she didn't tell jokes. The humor in her scenes usually came from men who treated her like a dumb blonde. The comedy scenes she played were similar to the humor Marilyn Monroe generated flawlessly. Many at the time recalled Langdon from the Thriller episode where she played a burlesque queen with a yen for rich old men. Or perhaps the Dick Van Dyke Show, where she was an accused criminal who made an ogling idiot of juror Rob Petrie. Sue Ane Langdon rarely carried a scene by herself, but is considered a perfect foil. Off-screen, she was quiet and rarely said anything even remotely humorous, so what could go wrong? Well, people didn't really see her as the comedy woman, but rather the funny, dumb blonde that would mask behind powerful or wealthy men. Sue was one of the few young actresses cast in the 50s who kept getting cast until 2010. Besides the Elvis films, she did another TV series, Arnie, a situation comedy with Herschel Bernardi, for two seasons that aired in the 70s. She also continued to work in front of a camera for several years. Sue even performed on stage at that time, including the production of Hello, Dolly. Her last screen credit was in Weird Al Yankovic's 1989 movie UHF, and in the two Zapped movies, released in 1982 and 1990. She was married 51 years to director Jack Emmerich until his death in 2010. As of 2021, she is 85 years old. Overall, she had a longer and more successful career than most of the other young actresses who came along during that era. Today, Sue Ane lives on a ranch in the San Fernando Valley, which is outfitted in Western-style antique Monterey furniture, of which she and her late husband, Jack Emmerich, were both passionate collectors. Is there something we missed about Sue Ane Langdon? Let us know in the comments and check out the next video in the series.